And we're back. And it's about to go down. Week 3 against the Buccaneers at home. Coming off a huge win against the Redskins. Without further ado, let's get into it. Matthew Kaufmann, What If They Went Pro, Episode 3. Time to start balling. We're going throwbacks on these guys. Let's go with it. We looking fly. Ooh, boy. See, we got the red on there. If we got the red, let's see if we get the red. Let's go with the red. Where's the creamsicles at? They got that old school. Creamsicles. I don't think it'll let us go blue on blue, though. I mean, blue against orange. So we'll take one for the team. See if we can go this version of the classic. It still looks pretty, you know, old school-ish. Let's get it going. Once again, y'all, thank y'all for the support, for all the likes, the shares, the subscriptions. Really appreciate y'all. Really appreciate the love.
Set to get started, and this ought to be a good one between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the New York Giants. I'll have scores around the league for you at the half, but it's time for a little football. So we'll hand it over to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, we welcome everybody to the Garden State. EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that
there
was
he is, the big dog.
Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This
dude's been
balling,
man.
As their guys
you
get
know,
set to match up,
had a you know lackluster game one, game two came back, balled out. AJ Brown's also been balling out. He's been one of the big reasons why we had a game. That was actually his last game. So we had a big game because of him last week as well.
Winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I
so,
watched...
So, let's see what we can do here. We have not been using Saquon a lot. So we're going to try and incorporate him more as well. Let's go. Already off to a good start.
First half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
They'll come up now, second and four from the 31. On second down.
Let's go. Ooh.
And he'll get this up only to about the 33.
Good game. 32 now.
2 yards. And it'll bring up a third and two more.
That's all about doing the dirty work right there defensively. Second and short yardage, that's all about plugging those gaps, not giving the running back a crease to run through, and that's a nice job to hold him just a couple and force a third down.
The play action fake.
Final. Oh! Could not hang on to it. Almost got him killed. Got to punt it. Crazy, man. It's all good.
New York set to take the field. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right?
So Tampa Bay's defense really coming to play so far.
Can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
But let's see if they're ready for this, though.
Here on this drive. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And he's going to get this one.
They were not ready for that whatsoever.
The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away.
Forgot to mention this earlier today, guys. Oh, let's go. Forgot to mention this earlier today, guys, but today is week one across the state for semi-pro football. Big game here in our backyard here in Austin. The Austin Vipers playing the Killeen Knights out in Killeen. Oh, let's go. You know, there's a couple of good games out there, man. I know Stampede are playing. Red Raiders are playing. Texas Crusaders are playing. So there's a good amount of good games out there, you know. I'll try and keep y'all updated with scores. I don't know if y'all follow semi-pro or if I have any fans that watch it. Oh, let's go. Big time rush. But yeah, that's where a lot of these names are going to be coming from as well, guys. First down. Let's go.
Two plays really illustrate how difficult it is to game plan against this guy, because you know he can throw the football, but how about his use of legs as well? What we call those broken plays, you can't account for them.
Yeah, those plays, those two that you just mentioned, a microcosm really of how he can hurt you.
See if we can hit either Brown or Ingram for this touchdown right here.
They've got a first and 10 at the 11. Looking to throw. Now he's forced out right.
Oh, snap. Try to get it with the legs instead. See if we can get Saquon in there.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can, and that's what he's done very well in this game.
Oh, almost. Not really.
A full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down.
That's a really alert defense there, because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense. Countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft and able to really make a big time play for their defense.
Out of the gun now on third down. Buying time to his left.
Oh, let's go.
It's a touchdown for the New York Giants. And after working on it all week, they're able to punch it in.
Let's go.
Nothing like good preparation and even better execution.
Another rushing touchdown for the homie Matthew Kaufmann. We got to get him going in the passing game now. So let's see what we can do here.
They go play action here on first down. That's caught.
Let's go.
Tight end Evan Ingram. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line.
So that's three rushing touchdowns this season. That's pretty dope. 3-3 games, I could dig it. Odell, let's go.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Get Saquon involved. You gotta wait for your block, Saquon. Dang.
Losing yardage back at the 35. That's gonna go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one,
let's go.
One of those guys.
Ingram once again. Big time.
Out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
on any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
Oh, you got to catch that, AJ. Wow.
Maybe a rookie mistake there, second down. These fifth rounders, and to use him as an example, maybe you take a little bit of a flyer on someone, hope you hit gold.
Exactly, because when you get into the fifth round, you're usually not counting on him to become a starter right away. But we've seen so many times, fifth, sixth, seventh, undrafted free agents who come in and make their way and in a big way.
They added a lot of talent to a roster.
Pressure here, and down he goes. Held it too long. Waiting for it to develop. Didn't develop. I felt the wrath.
Big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Let's go.
Over the middle to Beckham. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. He got 29 yards that time.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield.
See if Shepard can make a play here.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw.
Oh, man.
This throw here is incomplete.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
Right there.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. And a nice gain of 21 yards. They've made goal line offense a priority on the practice field this week. This is exactly the situation.
Oh, let's go.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 4 on the carry there at second and goal.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball in this drive, and not as much running it as we just saw once.
Let's go.
He's got it for a giant touchdown. As his guys are in for 6, and the Giants are in.
Can't stop us. Turnover, nice.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And that's complete.
Attaboy, Ellington.
So a good spin move there before he's taken down. A nice little gain. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver.
Oh, too much air on it.
Into a double team and
way too much air on it.
Picked off by Justin Evans.
Dang.
And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
That was way too much air under that. 41 seconds to score, no biggie. At least that isn't my fourth interception of the day, like week one.
This is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there.
Oh, snap.
I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. After the incompletion, they'll try once more from the 20-yard line on second and 10.
See what they counter with.
Back to throw now on second and 10. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. As they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll look to throw here on first down.
Let's go.
Well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
Let's go.
And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number 1. Now back to throw. Steps away to his left. And inside the 20.
No worries. Let's go. 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 Let's go.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw.
Oh, pick. Dang, right before the half, 2 picks. Dang. No worries. They haven't hurt us yet.
Here's the Giants offense now.
So now we just got to clean up the game.
Third quarter. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their
play. And with a flag down, he goes down. So they're able to sack him. Now the penalty looks like it could be holding. Let's find out.
Oh.
Offense.
So he takes the hit and still... No, they're probably going to decline it.
The sack instead of the penalty.
Oh, wow.
That takes another down okay, yeah. The series, but the biggest one of all, do you want to tell the guy who just got the sack that it no longer counts?
No.
No, not at all.
On play action, they'll throw.
Dang.
He's able to get up here to the 26. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
Looked at me like they adopted what my kindergarten teacher always said. If at first you don't succeed, try again. And finally, able to hold him in check.
Third and 22.
Carving him up running the ball.
That's the first time I think I've seen where the coverage was good downfield, and they accounted for him and stopped him for a short pickup.
Yeah, I don't think it was a...
Well, this is taken in.
Let's go. Let's go.
But not before he takes it inside the 40. A big gain of 38 there on third down.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice
Incredibly.
Attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
They'll set up a throw. And pops
Dang.
Three. The collision there jarred the ball loose. And
Can't believe he dropped that.
Down.
See what Saquon can do.
Back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands. Guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Kind of a muddle in the middle of the field.
Oh, come on, Saquon. Oh, man.
The reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter. No time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
That's a first, though.
Pick up a dozen yards there on the scramble.
Oh,
not enough.
Okay. No worries.
Field goal attempt.
Yes, we will pass up the field goal attempt.
Now they'll go for it on fourth.
Detroit!
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw.
Wow.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time.
Third pick, and this one might be for points.
He's at the 40. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
Incredible. Went from having a nearly flawless performance last week to now this week. Three picks yet again.
Receptions in this game, I would have to think. I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, you're like, oh man, I can't throw four. And down he
Damn.
Goes, a Buccaneer sack.
Vita Vea.
And they weren't in zone coverage, they were in man, and each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old-school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a Defensive Player of the Year at the other, and they just locked people down.
Being chased out left.
Nice block, 88.
Able to make something out
nice
of
block.
There. 17 yards and a first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Dancing to his left. Oh, nice move. And he'll be out
I don't know what that spin move was for, but, you know, got to get the moves in.
A first down as well.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into some windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception. What a
Dang.
To escape, and he goes down.
Massive.
In there to bury him for a loss of 11.
The amount of sacks.
Four sacks, three interceptions, and they're still down seven.
Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
He finds his target, Beckham. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. They'll drop the throw. He may try and run for this. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble.
under the category of obvious. You hate giving up a first down on third and long. And somehow he finds his way downfield and picks it up.
Yeah, if you look at the coverage defensively, this
is great. That guy keeps laying people out.
At some point, you actually have to tackle it and get him on the ground short of the first down marker.
Once again, guys, just want to appreciate y'all for tuning in. Ooh, almost another pick. For tuning in, guys, for sharing, liking. Like I said, man, y'all's love does not go unappreciated. Gonna drop a couple more videos today. Actually, a lot more videos today. You know, and start a couple new series as well. Maybe a 2K. Or even a or even a WWE one, you know. I got a WWE universe lined up. So, you know, just be expecting some new content. I'm also going to be dropping a TVS All-Star team. What if they made, you know, what if they were a pro team? And And I'm also going to do a Texas Extreme one and a Craffle All-Star or a Texas Semi-Pro All-Star one. So be on the lookout for those. But yeah, man, you know, we're going to be dropping a bunch of new content today, tomorrow. Monday night, got football practices. We got a big-time game week two against the Austin Vipers. You know, regardless if they win or not today, it's still going to be a big game. It's a big-time rivalry here in Austin. So, you know, looking forward to that. But yeah, man. Matthew Kaufmann. Got to fix up his stats a little bit, man. I'm kind of killing the stats here.
Time to his left. And they'll get it up to short of the 45 at the 44.
The rushing stats looking good, though. Looking very good.
By a few inches, that'll be a first down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw.
Ooh. Spence with two sacks today. We usually have big plays on these long down and distances.
I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same.
Oh, fumble.
And it's picked up by the Buccaneers.
Oh, wow. And they turn it into 7 or 6 the other way. Crazy, man. Wow. It's all good, man. We just got to put up points. 4 turnovers, 3 picks, 1 fumble. Not looking good, man. Not looking good.
He'll look to throw. On the move to his left. He'll complete this to Ingram, his tight end. And he's going to lose yardage.
But, I mean, when you're the quarterback for the Giants, it's kind of how you get down.
Loss on the play. And it'll be second.
But, no, we definitely got to clean it up, man. Definitely got to clean it up. Let's go. Attaboy, Odell. See, we can get 300 yards passing, man. Ooh, did not see that guy there.
Incomplete. The Pro Bowler Odell Beckham, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
And if y'all got any suggestions, guys, hop in the inbox, hop in the comment section. Let me know who y'all want to see. We'll also be doing some more Facebook polls. So y'all can let me know who y'all want to see. Ooh, let's go. Or what y'all want to see as well, you know. Because like I said, we got a whole bunch of games that we could do.
Another nice pickup through the air.
And actually, for my soccer fans, for all the soccer fans that are out there, all my friends that are soccer fans, I'm also going to be doing a FIFA rebuild or a rebuild in FIFA. Probably going to do Real Madrid, life after Ronaldo. God also do it, Barcelona. You know. So yeah, man. You know, we're gonna get content put out there. You know. Hopefully it's good content. You know. You know. Hopefully y'all like it. You know what I mean? Hopefully y'all are entertained.
NFL, because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center eligible stuff, but still a lot of guys to account for.
Dang. It's all good. We're just trying to put this game out already. Trying to leave with a dub. You know what I mean?
Third and four.
They're not ready for this, though.
He can run for it, and he will.
Let's go. 180, y'all. 180 rushing yards. That's a beast, man. Don't be fooled. This guy's also a beast in real life. One of the best RGB quarterbacks ever, y'all. I know that's a bold statement, but it's a true statement.
To see what happens after this. So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now they'll throw here out of the gun.
Irv Smith Jr. Money.
In for the score.
Let's go, y'all. I also want to do some MLB The Show, y'all. I got a super team already created on MLB The Show. But I don't want to bust it out like that. I might just do, like, you know, a couple of Road to the Shows. Got a couple dudes I went to school with back in Hidalgo that are in the majors, or at least in the farm systems. You know, Tres Barrera plays in the Washington Nationals farm system. Gerardo Pollo Reyes plays for the Padres in their farm system. So we get it rolling with them on the show. But yeah, man, so we're trying to diversify it too, you know what I mean? All the different sports fans out there. Let them know we ain't one-dimensional. We're also going to bust out some 2K, man. Like I said, Aaron Ramirez is going to be the first 2K career mode that we're going to bust out. I'm excited for that one. Nico Maxwell is another one. If you don't know who Nico Maxwell is, he was also pretty good, pretty great basketball player in the Valley and in San Antonio. And that's another touchdown. Let's go. Seems out of reach. We did what we had to do. Even though we turned the ball over a lot of times, it does not matter because we still escaped with the W. 35-14, yo.
And Charles, you know what coaches always
tell us. Check out these stats real quick. So 20 of 30 for 321. Not bad, except for the three interceptions, two touchdowns. One rushing touchdown, one fumble lost. 16 attempts, 182 yards. It's 11.3 yards per carry. Saquon's still pretty unproductive. But yeah, guys, once again, thank y'all for tuning in, man. Thank y'all for making it this far in the video. Really, really appreciate y'all, man. Really do, from the bottom of my heart. Thank y'all for all the support, all the likes, all the shares. If you haven't already, hit the subscribe button. Turn on your notifications so you know when I'm popping and dropping more videos. Let's do this upgrade real quick. Let's go West Coast. Nice. But yeah, man, really appreciate y'all, man, and I hope to grow this channel to great lengths. We are still gonna do that giveaway, man. So it's gonna be a $20 to $25 gift card for Nike, Whataburger, or GameStop. still trying to figure out how I'm gonna do it. As far as to do the giveaway, maybe if you drop a comment and a like for each video that I've dropped. I don't know. I'll figure it out. But yeah, y'all be ready for that as well, man. It's gonna be crazy. We're gonna do small giveaways first, you know, until we grow, and then from there we'll see where we can get it, man. But yeah, once again, man, appreciate y'all. I will be dropping some more heat later on today. Until then, y'all stay beautiful, guys.